This is your task to write.
Yes.
Some experts believe that it is better for children to begin learning a foreign language at primary school rather than secondary school. The advantages of this outweigh the disadvantages. All right, so they should be starting their learning for foreign languages in their primary rather than secondary. Advantages of learning in primary outweighing the disadvantages. Are they? Let's see. Okay. So these are the idea you have prepared. How much time did you spend on preparing the ideas for writing task 2?
10 minutes, sir.
All right. And how much time it took you to complete your writing task 2?
About 25 minutes, and 5 minutes I devoted to the after completion the task. Yeah.
Right. How many words are here on this one?
About 270 or 280.
Okay, no problem.
Nearly.
Right. It has a... What is it, treat as a basic language like Hindi and English? Will not take it as a burden due to basic language. All right. I want to insult food. Children have more sharp memory than adults. They can easily grab the new information. No problem. Good. This is the importance of national language decreases. By giving more emphasis on foreign language, they forget about their main language, their national identity, you can say, but this one is also okay, no problem. Negative impact on national language distinction. When they become adults, they will treat their national language as inferior language. Right. Okay, let's start. Many experts trust that trust.
Yes, sir.
It will be better for pupils to start learning. Start over high school. I'm going to discuss about the merits and demerits of the statement in upcoming body paragraphs. Okay. So this is your introduction, and it has two sentences. The first one is the paraphrase of your statement, right?
Yes.
The statement is, some experts believe that it is better for children to begin learning a foreign language at primary school rather than secondary school. And you're seeing here, some experts trust. Trust is not a good word as compared to believe. Believe and trust are the synonyms, you can say that, but believe is absolutely perfect in that context, but trust is not a suitable word here in this context. Many experts say that you can say whatever you want to say, but see, what is it? Content?
Concur.
So I didn't get the word. What is it?
Concur. C-O-N-C-U-R.
Ah, right. No problem. Okay. And so this is the paraphrased of your statement. Okay, so this is the complete paraphrasing, right? And the second sentence is your opinion. But let me go back to the question here. It's saying here, do the advantages of this outweigh the disadvantages? They're asking you a question. Do you think these advantages are outweighing the disadvantages? Means which one is stronger, the advantages or disadvantages? Means is it worth taking the risk of sending the children into that school where they can learn the foreign language in the starting? In the elementary, in the starting of their schools, right? in the primary, in the elementary, and not in the
I
secondary,
see.
okay? So, but you're saying here, I'm going to discuss about the merits and demerits of the statement in the upcoming body paragraphs. Shouldn't we have the definer, the here, the article? Because we know the upcoming paragraphs,
In the up
me and you, we both know. This is a definer. So whenever you need to define
Okay.
something, and you need to use the article, the here, right? So when we read a sentence, when the writer means you and the reader means me, knows what we're going to talk about, what we're talking about here, right? So I know the paragraph that you're talking about here, and you also know because you were writing it. So if we both know, then the word "the" should be here, the article "the" should be here, okay? Otherwise it's fine. But
Okay.
let's talk about your opinion. The question is asking you whether the advantages are outweighing the disadvantages, whether the advantages are stronger than disadvantages. You're saying that you're going to discuss the advantages and disadvantages in the upcoming paragraphs, but you did not say
Yes, sir.
whether the advantages are stronger than the disadvantages, whether the advantages are outweighing the disadvantages. You did not say that in your introduction. So your opinion is not clear. Means there's no opinion here, right? Although there's nothing wrong with this
Yes,
sentence,
sir.
but in case of this question, it won't work. If they have asked you only what are the advantages and disadvantages of learning foreign language in the primary school, then it's okay. Getting my point?
Can we give our opinion in the conclusion?
We need to give our opinion in the conclusion. But if you're looking for more than 7 band, or even if you're looking for 7 band in writing, you need to have a clear opinion in the introduction.
Okay, sir.
Getting my point?
Yes, sir.
Okay, here. On the positive side of the statement, if learning foreign language is given to the children in primary school, they will treat their language as a basic language like Hindi and English. They will not take it as an extra burden. As an outcome, more interest can be developed among the children. What is this? As an outcome, more
They
interest
will
can be developed
learn this
among the children.
yes, sir, about the learning the foreign language.
Let me find your topic statement here. Basic, right?
Yes, sir.
And then you're saying that they will not take it as an extra burden. So as an outcome, they will generate more interest in developing the foreign language. They will generate more interest, right? So what they're getting at the end, interest. They will have more interest in learning foreign language, right? And how this interest will be
Yes, sir.
developed in them? Because they will treat it as a basic language.
Yes,
Yep.
sir. Like Hindi and English.
For instance, we'll learn Hindi and English from our basic classes or elementary classes, and we start to get more indulged in these subjects. The same result can be shown in learning a foreign language. English is a foreign language. What do you
What, sir?
think? English, what do you think English? Is English a foreign language? Hello,
No,
you
sir.
there? English is not a foreign language?
Yes, sir. English is also a basic language in our India nowadays.
Yeah, it is. So there are lots of people who speak French as well. There are
That's
people
right.
here who speak Chinese, who speak Russian as well.
Correct.
So what do you think
Yes,
about
sir.
those languages? Are they foreign or not?
These are the foreign languages.
What makes a language a foreign language?
What, sir?
What makes a language a foreign language? You understood my question?
Can you repeat the question, please? Your
I'm
voice is
saying
not clear.
that what makes a language a foreign language? We people speak English, right? We people speak Chinese, Japanese, Russian, right? But we don't use the language, the other language, in our official documents. But English can be seen in official documents, in the government documents.
Yes, sir. Because Chinese, French, these are the not the original language.
These are not the
So they have their origin. No, sir.
they are what, sorry, can you tell me again?
They are not originated from our country.
So do you think English originated in India? Hello.
No, sir.
So
Yes, sir.
So orig
No,
so origin
India
of
doesn't.
something, so origin of something tells us that the this is this the native or not?
I think most people who speak language in our country becomes the basic language.
No, it's not
As
about basic, it's about
nowadays
the foreign
India is not.
language. It's not about the basic language, it's about the foreign language. The question is about the foreign language. That's what they're saying. We people speak English a lot, but still, we have there's a lots and lots of number of people who face difficulty in speaking in English.
But
Even
in
if we have
many
English as a as a subject in our school since our childhood, but still people can't speak English. If they face difficulty.
they generally face difficulty because they don't have in such an environment where they can speak English fluently, I think.
So,
The
but
most
Hindi, in Hindi, they don't face difficulty. They speak it very well.
Because they speak Hindi in their regular life, so it
So
varies if.
speaking Hindi in our regular life makes it a native language, but speaking English is in only at certain time, only in school, let's say only in businesses, only in the professional, as a professional, that doesn't make it native.
No, sir. But nowadays people are focusing more on learning English in many states of India. English is
So that makes
preferable
it
than.
that so that makes it a native language. It's not a foreign language, that's what you're saying.
I
Okay,
think
so
because India today India don't have any national language.
yeah, we don't have national language. We have official language. Our official language is Hindi. Do we have English as official as
Yes,
well?
sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, so two languages are official. But again, all right, so your sentence is saying here, if you take a look at your writing task too, they will not take it as an extra burden, and as an outcome, more interest can be developed among the children. For instance, we learn Hindi and English from our basic classes, and we start to get more indulged in these subjects. The same result can be seen shown in learning a foreign language. This is the thing that makes me wonder, Is English a native language or is a foreign language? English brought
I
into our
didn't
country.
use the words natural
But you're saying
I
that
didn't
same
use
can
word
be.
natural.
Yeah, if you read your previous sentence here, you're saying that we start to get indulge more in these subjects. It means Hindi and English, we indulge more. Right? That's what you're saying. But the same can be seen in foreign language. That means you're saying English is not a foreign language. English was brought into our country by the Britishers. And since then we are indulging in it. We are using it. Furthermore, children have sharp memory during their childhood. Huh. What is the advantage then? Because they have sharp memory, that's the advantage. They can easily grab new information, even it is related to learning an abroad language. How? So what is the benefit here then? You there?
Yes, sir.
You're saying the benefit
Learning a new
of
abroad.
learning a foreign language in the primary school is that they have a sharp memory. That's the benefit. And then you explained it in the next sentence where you're saying that they can grab the new language easily.
Should I use the grab new information as a benefit?
No, I'm worrying about your idea here. You're saying that the benefit of learning foreign language in the primary school is that they have a sharp memory. Children has sharp memory. That's the benefit.
Grabbing the new information.
Huh.
Is the benefit
So
which we
if you
consider
say
during the childhood?
if you say that by having sharp memory, children can grab new words of a foreign language easily, right? And how can they do that? Because it's been proven scientifically. It's been proven scientifically that the children can learn any language, any accent, any dialect, right? It's just that they need to be into that environment. That environment can be created in the elementary classes, and then they can learn it easily. It's up to you, the way you want to put it, but yeah, you need to think of your idea and explanation very carefully. Apart from this, so now we're moving on to the demerits. There have some demerits. There have some demerits of it. There are some demerits of it. Okay, while focusing on an international language, the importance of national language will automatically decrease. Okay, how it will decrease? Children will lose the value of their language. How will they lose it?
I have clarified it with an example.
Okay, so in India, due to the increasing trend of Western culture, people are giving more importance to English. Huh?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so E must be capital here. Now let me take you back to your paravan. Here you said that we learn Hindi and English from our basic classes, means from our elementary classes, and so we generate interest in it, we indulge more in it. But the same can be done in case of foreign language. Means here you were saying that English is not a foreign language, but here you're saying that English is a foreign language. You did not write it, but Yeah, it seems to be that you're saying that English is a foreign language here. Here, if you read it again, the importance of national language will automatically decrease, right? You said that.
Yes.
So if I consider the national language, well, we don't have the national language, right? We have the official language, right? So
Yes,
here,
sir.
let's say, so children will lose the value of their own language. Okay, so they will lose the value of their own language. That means they will lose the value of English and Hindi both. But if then your example in India, due to the increasing trend of Western culture, people are giving more importance to English instead of their own language. Here you're saying their own language, Hindi. Here you're saying that English is not our native language. It's the foreign language. Here you were justifying you were supporting your this sentence by saying English is not a foreign language.
I made mistakes in the first paragraph. I didn't include
Okay.
English.
Thank you for accepting
I
that.
better.
Okay. No
I
problem.
should not include English because English is a foreign language.
Okay, fine. No problem. I'm happy. And I'm happy to win here. Sorry about that. I shouldn't say that. I'm really bad at it. Okay. Along with this, right, how many words of your para 2 has?
About 110 maybe.
110 your para 2 and your para 1?
105, I think.
Okay. From tomorrow, you do this writing task 1 and task 2 on the answer sheet that I shared with you. Yeah? So that I'll get the
Okay.
clear picture of the actual size of your para 1 and para 2. Along with this, the fear of extinction of Hindi is the another demerit of it. Now, we need to talk about this one too. If our focus will be more on learning other languages, then one day will come, then that day will come. That day will come when our basic language will extinct. Basic language, Hindi is not a basic language, it's our native language.
Basic.
What do you mean by basic here?
Which we get from our
Ancestors.
yes, sir, ancestors.
But the word basic is not a good one then here. Ancestral language you can say. Native language you can say. And even if using this word that the Hindi will extinct, you should be very careful because we have lots and lots of people who use Hindi to speak. And one language can extinct when there are fewer number of people talking in that language.
I didn't explain the scenario of today, but I explained about the future. If we will focus more on
So
other
then
learning other languages.
how much in future have you shared that one here? And this is your idea. And H of Hindi must be capital.
Okay.
How deep in the future we need to go to see Hindi being extinct here? One day will come, that day will come when our basic language will extinct. Consequently, our existence will become disappear one day. Okay, this is, I see, irrelevant.
But which one?
This one here, consequently, our existence will become disappear one day. How we are
Irrelevant.
talking in our language will extinct our appearance on the planet Earth.
Because due to the extinction of our native, our basic language.
So only the language that makes us Indian. Yeah.
It is the most important part of, I
It
think,
is. It is most important
English.
part. It is. Seriously, it is the most important part. It is. Right? But yeah, this sentence is, I see, irrelevant. For instance, in India, the basic language is Hindi. So why are you using the word basic all the time? But due to the lots of diversity in India, people need to learn English, E must be capital, even if they have to go in other state. Like in South India, S must be capital, and North India, N and E must be capital side of India. I think I is capital, all right, that is okay. What are you talking about then here? Fear of extinction of Hindi will is the another re demerit of it. So this is a demerit that why did you should not use the language word here. The one language might extinct, that you can say. You can talk about Sanskrit here if you want to, because we do not use Sanskrit to communicate with the other people, right? We only
Yes,
use
sir.
it when in our minds rituals and practices, but other than that, we don't use Sanskrit to talk to people. So that you can say, if we lose our culture, then Sanskrit might die, but Hindi is the other thing. We're still using
Okay.
Hindi, although the quality, I would say quality of Hindi has decreased a lot. We're not using the level of Hindi that we used to have a couple of hundreds of years ago. And that same goes to the other language, in case of other languages, even in the case of English as well. If you read the literatures written hundreds of years ago, and then you'll see the difference of the vocabulary and the dialect they're using in those literatures. But nowadays it is very easy to understand English. Seriously, I have one novel written around in 1870, 1880s, and that is Woman in White. Okay, have you read it?
No, sir.
So I read it, but it was really difficult to understand this novel because the language is really hard. Written in English, but really hard to understand. And nowadays, the novels that are written nowadays, I can read them easily and I can understand them easily. So the quality, you can say, has decreased and will decrease, but the extinction of one language is a really it's a long process. And you have written the word Hindi over here. Okay, so here you're talking
Should
about.
I hear Sanskrit? Should I hear discuss about the Sanskrit language instead of Hindi?
I'm not saying that. I'm just saying that you should not use the language name of the language here. Sorry. So you're saying here that the language might extinct if we focus on the other language from the starting. Yeah, that's what you're saying, right? Okay. So how did you explain it? How the language will extinct? Because if you focus more on the other languages, will basic language. Okay. Again, how will that extinct? You said here in the idea that the language might extinct if we start learning foreign language from the elementary classes, but how will that extinct? If I read this one for answering that question, I find if you focus more on learning other languages, then one day will come that the basic language will extinct. But how will it extinct? Because we will use that language more. Because the next generation is learning the foreign language and not learning their basic language or their native language, right? And if
Yes, sir.
we have lesser number of people speaking the native language, then it will extinct automatically. That's how the language is extinct, I guess. And if we do not have anything written in those languages. So this sentence was irrelevant, I told you that. So if you read the example again, basic language is Hindi, but due to lots of diversity in India, people need to learn English even if they have to go to other states like in South India and North in East side of India. So what is the relevance of this example to your explanation?
Because it explains the importance of only English, not of Hindi.
So,
If we use in English more and more, then one day Hindi will be extinct.
English, you're saying, is a common language amongst the North Indian and the South Indian, if we just talk about this one only, right? Right, we people living in North India, and if we go into the South India side, we can communicate with them, and they can communicate back to us. We don't need to learn their language. So English is we're using here as a bridge with the harm we have here to Hindi, and how Hindi will exchange if we are just talking about English to communicate with the other people. One thing we can do is that either we start learning Tamil, Telugu, and other languages, Marathi, and or we can tell them to learn Hindi as a common language. So English we're using here
Yes.
as a bridge, and how we are communicating with them in English, making Hindi extinct. We have talked about this. The idea need to be on the top. The explanation links back to the idea, okay, and then the example linked back to the explanation. So your explanation is saying that it will extinct. How? It doesn't say that, okay, but the
Yes.
example here is not relevant to your explanation. Or if you can justify it by saying, then I am all ears. I can hear it, no problem. Tell me how your example is relevant even to your idea that you have written up there. Okay,
As
in a
I
nutshell,
said that
tell me please.
Hindi will Hindi is not preferable during nowadays to go in many other states of India. English is preferable. So I think it loses the importance of Hindi.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. This you need to do it again, I think.
Yes, sir. Idea relevance is wrong, I think. Idea generation is not up to the mark.
So what you need to do is that take the same question again and write the question on the top here. Yeah, and
okay.
Then generate your ideas and then do your writing. Okay.
Okay, sir.
So try doing it again. I'll give it 6 band for your task 1 and task 2 altogether. If the other IELTS examiner check it, they might give you 6.5. Okay, but I see lots and lots of irrelevancy amongst your ideas, your explanation, and your example.
Okay, sir.
Should
I
right.
have given listening and reading test as well?
Okay, we'll talk about that one in a minute. Okay.
Okay, sir.